Cognigy provides the ability to localize flows using locales. In this short video, I'll talk about the purpose of locales, how they work, and when they're a good fit for your localization needs. The most straightforward reason to use locales is when you need to translate your flows. Imagine you have a customer base, some of whom speak English, some who speak Spanish, and some who speak Chinese. We'll focus on this scenario and then discuss other scenarios towards the end of the video. To localize my flows, the first thing I'll do is go to the left bar and look under Manage, then Localization. On this screen, I can view the locales that have already been created. By default, we start with ENUS as the primary locale. That's because I chose that language when I first created the agent. I'll create a new locale and give it a name, in this case Spanish, and choose Spanish for my NLU language. I can also use a fallback locale. We only have one other locale in this case, so we'll keep it as English. The fallback locale is used if there isn't any content configured for the current locale. So if Cognigy hits a node that hasn't been translated, it uses the content from the fallback locale instead. I'll save, and now I have my new locale. I'll go back to the input flow we created several lessons ago. Now, at the top of the screen, I have a dropdown that lets me choose locales. I'll choose Spanish. You'll see that all of my nodes turn gray. That indicates that they haven't yet been translated. I'll click on the welcome message. In the editor panel, I see an Add Localization button, and I can see that the current fallback locale is US English. I can click Add Localization, and I have the option to either copy from another locale or start from scratch. I'll choose Add Empty Localization. And for the text, I'll put the following. To test it out, open the Interaction panel, and now you'll see a drop-down at the top called Locale. If I say hi to my bot, it will respond in Spanish. I can continue to translate the rest of the flow so the bot can speak to users in their native language. Note that so far I've been talking about what the bot says to a user. But how can the bot understand a Spanish-speaking user when I've just created English language intents? If I click on the NLU tab and choose my Carry On intent, you see I have the ability to add a localization. I'll add an empty localization and can start adding example sentences in Spanish. Note that any intent that hasn't been localized is disabled, as Cognigy won't be able to detect the intent without example sentences. I can specify which locale to use for a conversation in my endpoint. In the left bar, I'll go to Deploy, Endpoints, and open my web endpoint. In my endpoint configuration, I can choose Spanish. I'll change the flow to my input flow. I'll save and open the web chat. And you can see it starts talking to me in Spanish. What if I want to change from one language to another? For example, the locale for my endpoint is English, but I want to change to Spanish if that's the user's preference in a CRM record, or if they explicitly choose an option on the website or the chat window. For this, we have a Switch Locale node. I'll go back to my input flow, and, just for demonstration purposes, I'll add a Switch Locale node under my welcome message. I'll switch the locale to Spanish and save. I can test by saying hi in my interaction panel with ENUS selected. It gives me a response in English. If I say hi again, it gives me the response in Spanish. Locales are a great feature in Cognigy for providing conversations in your customer's preferred language. But before we end the video, let's tackle some alternative approaches. First off, many people ask, can Cognigy translate my flows automatically? The answer is yes. Cognigy provides a translation transformer that can dynamically translate inputs and outputs to the user's language of choice. Second, it's good to consider whether translation is sufficient. For example, your products or services may differ substantially from one region to another. There could be different business processes or culturally unique ways of talking about things that aren't addressed by translating the same flow to another language. You might need a combination of translated flows and language-specific flows, the latter being flows that are designed to reflect the business processes for a specific region.